So today we're talking actually about one of my favorite topics, and it's because I come from the post-production world where we deal with hardware of computing machines, servers, and all of that fun networking stuff as well. And we just got the new 16-inch MacBook Pro in studio. For some of the nerdy details, this is the latest 16-inch MacBook Pro, space gray because I like gray. So I spec'd out this machine specifically because I think it's gonna suit a lot of our needs for 2020 and the upcoming projects we have, which are a lot more mobile editing projects. Having a 2 terabyte internal SSD is going to allow me to cut internally without the need for an external SSD. For a lot of the situations that we run into, we'll back all of our stuff up to 1 or 2 SSDs externally. But when we're actually editing in the field, we can go straight off the internal drive, which is going to be super helpful because it saves battery life because you're not powering another device. And it's also less problematic because you don't have a hard drive or an SSD sitting next to you that can be bumped or somehow damaged. So being able to do that all internally on this laptop is going to be awesome. But one of the things that you have to do before you even get this thing into production is set it all up. And most people don't realize how easy it is to migrate your data from your old laptop over to your new one. Apple has made that really simple, and for the last couple of decades, this is the method that we use. It's called target disk mode. So basically, you start up your old machine, you power it up, and you press the T key. So T stands for target disk. It'll get you into a mode where basically your old laptop now functions like an external disk. And it's an SSD internally, so it's gonna be super fast. And you wanna make sure that you actually have power on this guy because it's gonna take a little while to transfer all your information. So just make sure that you have your power in your old laptop. Then you're gonna power up your new laptop. You're gonna make sure that that guy has power as well. It's gonna go through the basic startup mode of any new Apple. You're gonna speed through all of this stuff. You wanna try to connect to your existing wireless because it'll allow you to connect to your Apple user ID, and Apple uses some of that information to actually get your user set up when you're migrating all this information over. You're gonna get on here. So you're gonna come to this screen that says transfer information to this Mac. And this is where you're gonna plug in your old machine with a Thunderbolt cable. And it's really important that you look for the Thunderbolt symbol. It looks like a lightning bolt. You see that on this screen right here, but you also gotta make sure that it's on your cables because there are cables that look very, very similar that transfer data at USB-C speeds. Thunderbolt actually has a higher throughput rating with a more consistent bandwidth. So you wanna make sure you're using Thunderbolt cables, Thunderbolt 3 cables. You're gonna plug one side into your target disk and you're gonna plug the other side into your new laptop. So what you can do now is you say, I'm gonna transfer from a Mac. You hit continue. So it starts looking for the old Mac. Once it finds this Mac on the system, it'll allow you to transfer that data directly over. And then it's gonna ask you to enter the password for the old user that you're trying to migrate. So it has to be a user that had administrative rights on the old machine so that you can transfer everything over. If you have multiple users, you can transfer all of that information over as well, but you just wanna make sure that the user that you're logging into and providing credentials for is an administrator. So you can transfer over applications, you can transfer over different users, and you can transfer over all your settings and all your folders and files. So that's why you credential everything with an administrative user in the beginning. So you have the permissions to actually transfer over everything. So you'll see this thing pinwheeling for a little bit, and it's basically calculating how much data you need to transfer over from the old machine. This is actually a great time to determine which users you want to transfer over, because if you have multiple users on your old system, sometimes you don't need to transfer over all of that information because it transfers over the photos and the documents that belong to that user as well. So if you just want to start with one new clean user, this is a great time to do that. So you just select all the ones that you want to migrate over. I'm going to uncheck one of these. I'm going to make sure that my primary user is selected, as well as the applications. And then you just hit continue. And so what you can do at this point, you can keep your old password or you can set a new password for your user. So we'll set a new one. set, and continue. It wants you to go through some of the terms and conditions, all that stuff, you'd agree, and now we wait. So this is gonna take all of the old information, and I think most importantly is all the applications. So back in the day, it actually took tons of time just to go through, install everything, get all the right serial numbers, pull out all the old cards with all that information, get the right users, and download and re-update all your apps. This automates all of that. So all of your Adobe information, all of your system information, all of that stuff gets migrated over for you automatically. That's one of the best parts about this. And even syncing through with Dropbox, all of those types of things, this takes all the manual labor of that out of it. So once this is done, we'll wrap it up and we'll have a brand new laptop that we can take out into the field. And that wraps it up for this episode. I hope that was helpful for you, because I know this saves me tons of time in setup and process. But this is gonna take about 6.5 hours. 6.5 hours. Yeah, I'm transferring over about 900 gigs of data over this Thunderbolt cable and all of the accoutrement that actually goes into making this system work. If you've got any questions about this process in particular, how we transfer data or how we move things around in studio, let me know in a comment below, shoot me a DM, or connect with me on social media. I'd love to hear about how you transfer data, about how you work in your own operations. And we'll catch you on the next one. Aloha.